Hey everyone, today we're going to learn how to do a lower third animation. We're also going to learn how to take our image and crop it into different shapes as well. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, welcome back. If you haven't checked out my website already, go ahead and check out my website at learningdojo.ninja. Here you can check out all of my previous blog posts. You can also check out templates on Articulate Storyline. Camtasia videos will be coming soon as well. XAPI templates as well. You can also check out full courses on Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom Scorm, and HTML5 video. So I'm going to do a couple different things today inside of Camtasia. Hopefully this will help you up your skills inside of Camtasia and go beyond just screen recording. So I have a project pulled up here, and this is a previous project that I've worked with. And you can see that I have my live video, but as soon as I come to this point, I want to swap to my screen recording, but I still want my live video to be down at the bottom and I want it to be in a circle. So I'm going to use a track mat inside of Camtasia here in order to accomplish this. First of all, I'm going to rearrange this because I want this video to be on top. And wherever you want this video to come in, that's usually where I make a split. And so you can just hold down your video and hit Command T to make a split, or you can do Control Command T, or you can do Command Shift T and that will split everything, or Control Shift T on them. And I think it might be P or something on a PC. And I'm probably do a PC version of this video later on. But right now, I'm gonna just swap this out because I want this to be on the bottom. So I'm gonna take track 3 and I'm gonna swap it down here. So right now, just my live video is on top, but that's okay because I'm gonna take that live video and I'm gonna make it smaller and I'm gonna make it inside of a circle. Now, I also split out at the end of that live video where I want that to stop and how I want it to just come back to the live video, just similar to this, how you're going from the screen recording to the live video. Now, I don't always do this for my videos. If you've watched my YouTube channel, I don't always put myself in a little shape down at the bottom, but I'm just showing you that you could do this if you wanted to, just to keep your video live, basically. Because I have my screen kind of pointed to the side, so I don't think it looks really well, you know, if I'm just looking that way the entire time. But if you're facing the camera the entire time, I think this might look a little bit better. So I'm going to come over to here, and we're going to, first of all, zoom out, and you can use your scroll wheel on your, if you hover your mouse over the video area and you use your scroll wheel, this is how you can zoom in and out. And then I'm going to take this, and I'm going to make this, I have the wrong one selected, so I'm going to select my in-person video, and I'm going to resize this. Now, it will keep it proportional for you. If you hold the shift button down, then that's how it will disproportionate. It might look squished and other things, so avoid that. But I'm going to come into my annotations here, and I'm going to take my circle shape, and I'm going to take that circle shape and place it right over my face there. I want to make sure that this is proportional, so I'm going to go into the video here. I'm going to unlock that so I can adjust this to an exact dimension here, and I'm going to go to 400. I don't know why it doesn't go exactly to 400. It adjusted it to 399 for some reason, but it works. And I'm going to take this shape, and I'm going to get rid of the outline as well. So just take that thickness down to 0. It really doesn't matter because we're going to use this as a mask, and so it will actually just remove it anyways, but I just one extra thing I don't have to worry about there. So I'm going to take this and stretch my circle out for this entire cut period here. And I'm going to group these together because when you're doing a track mat, you may not want to have that track mat because what will happen, that track mat will affect everything under that track mats. And so I don't want it to affect everything. I only want it to affect this part of the video. So I'm going to group those two together. So I'm holding down the shift button and then I'm going to right click and go to group. Now I can go into that group, and then inside of that group, if you right click on the eyeball here, you can go to alpha. Now when you go to alpha, what happens is it will just, everything around that shape goes away, and the only visible part is within that shape. And so right now it gives us that circle, and this could be whatever shape that's inside of the annotation window. So if you use like a square or something like that, or you can use this to crop or other things. So there's a lot of flexibility here. But notice I'm not getting exactly a circle shape here. So I may want to take my shape and I may want it to go a little bit smaller there. So I could just hold the shift button down just to make sure it stays proportional, and then move that around until I get it the exact position that I want it. And you can zoom in to get it to see it a little bit better just by using your scroll wheel. But I think that's a lot better there. Now I can exit out of that group, and I could take that group and I could just move that to the bottom corner there. So I'm zooming out so I can see the entire thing, and there we go. Now, as soon as I get to that part of the video, I'm automatically in the circle. What if I wanted this to animate in? Well, I can do that by going into the group, and then you can animate the shape. So if I come in here to animation, and if I select animation, and then let's just do a custom one, let's have the point A, the first part of this, actually in my properties, let's have that be zero. So now you can see that that kind of bounces up there. So if you animate that shape, it will animate, it doesn't animate the video. You'd probably want to animate the video too if you wanted them to come up at the same time. You could do that, but if you just want the kind of crop to animate in, then you just animate the shape. So I think that's looking okay for now, so I'm going to go ahead and just leave it at that. Now what we're going to do is I'm going to zoom back in here, and if I needed to place this kind of in the middle, I can use the hand icon to move this in the middle. For some reason, my shortcut keys don't work on that. I wish there were some shortcut keys so I could just swap between those pretty easily, or have this kind of centered in the middle there, but that's fine. So what I want to do now is I want to add some animation, like a bar that comes up and my icon, my Learning Dojo icon, to kind of pop up right there. So I'm going to use my shapes. So under annotation, I'm going to go into shapes, drag out my first shape, and then I'm going to just drag this out to be a little bit longer to kind of stretch that area. Now, I like to get this kind of all placed together before I start to do the animations. Now I'm going to come into the visual effects. I'm going to add a drop shadow to that one just so it kind of stands out a little bit more. And I'm going to make sure that that is kind of centered in the middle there. There we go. I think that looks great. I'm going to change this to kind of a darker blue color. So I can go into the shape settings, go into my blue section here, and then we're going to have another shape, and that other shape, we kind of stretch this out, but this other shape is going to, oh, I think that's kind of getting cropped out there. Let's see. There we go. It was behind the video, so that's why I couldn't see both of them. But I'm going to have the top shape be a lighter blue. And this one, both of them, because I copied and pasted them, both of them have the drop shadow, which I don't want both of them to have. So I'm going to get rid of that first drop, on the first one, I'm going to get rid of that drop shadow. Okay, so we can have that animate in, we can have that animate in right after, but let's go into the annotation and let's get kind of a square here as well. So I'm going to come into here and then adjust the properties, uncheck that so I can resize this exactly, and then I'm going to come in here and just, might have to hold the shift button to keep it proportional now, but I'm going to come in here and have this kind of off to the side. I want it to overlap a little bit, and then I want my icon there as well. So I'm going to go into my media here, and I don't have my icon there. I'm going to go get my icon. All right, so I have my icon there, so I'm going to drag this in, stretch this out a little bit more, and let's just kind of place that icon right over the white box. All right, so I think that looks good. One more thing I want to do is I want to add an annotation, and we're going to add some text here. So I can go into the text section, and I want to have some text right above here. Now this is where it will say my name. And I'm going to make this text a little bit smaller, and I'm going to have it left justified. All right, there we go. Now let's make sure that all of these are kind of lined up together for now. But now we can start to add some animation. I'm going to zoom into this part. I'm going to use the hand tool to move over. Now we can start to add one animation after the other. So the first thing I want to do is I want to add this animation. Let's switch back to the selection tool here. But I want to have this animate in from the left to the stage here. And then I want to have the other one animate in, and then I want to have the icons pop up after that. So we'll kind of adjust this here in a second. Now I can just use a custom animation. And we're going to have point B, which is the ending point. This is going to be where it's exactly at right now. But point A, if I come into point A here, I want this to be off the stage. So I'm just going to drag that off the stage. Same thing with this other one. Point B, the ending point, is going to be where it's at now. But point A is going to be where it's off stage here. So if I adjust this or play my cursor, notice how both of them come in at the same time. Also, both of them kind of bounce. I don't want the bounce, and so I'm going to go into animation and switch this to exponential in and out, and then switch that one as well. And then you can see right here how both of them kind of come in. But we want to stagger this, and so we want one after the other. So the first one will come in, and then the second one. So just to give a little bit of style to it. Now I want the shape to come in slightly after that, and I want the first one to bounce up and rotate at the same time. So we're going to go into custom, and I'm going to come into custom, and I can adjust the timing here in a second. But I want point A to be set to zero, but I want the rotation to also be set to kind of like 90. So you can see here how it will come up, and you can see the outline. It's going to just kind of rotate, and there we go. Now this one, I do want to bounce it, so I'm going to go to animation and then spring. And now you can see how it will come up, bounce a little bit, and then go back. Well, I want the same thing with the icon, but I want the opposite rotation. So I'm going to just select that, drag and drop. But point A is going to be... Now, keep track of that, because when I brought this in, it was set to 100%. Let me stretch this back out, but it was set to 100%. I adjusted it down to 15%. So we're not going to go back up to a full 100%. We're going to go up to 15.6. So keep that in mind. So I'm going to just have this go down to zero, and I'm going to have the rotation go the opposite way. So now it's going to go from negative 90 to 100, and we kind of get that nice effect of both of them kind of coming in and rotating at the same time. I think that's looking great. So one more thing I want to do is I want to have my text come in slightly after that. And we can go into the behavior section. And the behavior section offers a lot of text animation. And it's pretty simple animation. And you can see that it will be like drifting, explode, pop in, and so forth. So I can just drag that in. Now this works a little bit different than that point A to point B animation. I actually have to select this and then click on where it says pop up here. And then the behaviors and how I change the behaviors is over on the right hand side. So right now this is set to hinge as far as pop up. I don't want it to be hinge. Let's have this actually be grow and notice how it starts to grow. But I don't want each letter at one time to grow. I want this whole thing to grow together. So I can go into type, and then I can just click on object. And then now it will start to animate in, bounce out a little bit, and there we go. Now I can adjust the tension. How much does this actually bounce? Do I want it to bounce a lot? Do I want it to bounce a little bit? It's up to you here in the tension. So now you can see here, it will start to bounce. Or I could just, you know, if I don't like the pop-up, in fact, I'm not really liking it too much, I can select that and delete it. And then maybe I could just have it slide. So right here, slide in. And then I'm going to have this slide text from right to left. So now let's take a look at that. There we go. But I want it to slide under the icon. So I can just rearrange the tracks here. And now it will slide in under the icon. Well, let's say that we don't want it to slide in one at a time. If you go text right to left, let's do object instead of text. And then now the whole thing will slide in together. I think that looks a lot better. And then we'll probably want this to slide on the behavior. It automatically has a slide out. I'd want to change that to object as well. And you can see that that will slide out, but not, we don't want it right to left. So I'm going to select that easing again. We actually want it to slide out to the left. And I probably want that to come out first before these other ones start to go as well. So it's all about timing and adjusting the timing and adjusting the settings and animation and so forth. So I want this text to go down again. So let's go into our animation, add a custom animation here, and we're going to have this kind of animate down. So right now we're just going to do the opposite of what we did before. We had it start at zero and then we had it animate up, but now we want it to go back to zero. So coming into the scale, I'm going to go ahead and just slide that down to 0 or 1%, and let's have it rotate back to negative 90. There we go. And then we're going to do the same thing here. We're going to have this adjust, and I can worry about timing here in a second. But we're going to have this one set to, let's go into the shape here. We're going to have this go to 0, and we're going to have this one actually go to 90 as far as rotation goes. There we go. So now I can see how that will pop out and this. I'm going to move that over. Let's just have this kind of timed out evenly now. That one doesn't make sense to have it bounce at the end, so I'm going to adjust this to exponential in and out and have this one also be exponential in and out as well. So now you can see it starts to rotate and go down. And we'll want to do the same thing with the shapes. As soon as that comes out, maybe we want this shape to come in or slide out first, and then we want that slide out second. So it takes time to do these things, but I'm going to show you how to actually save time to reuse this over and over in different projects. I'm going to slide that out as well, and there we go. So we have our little icon going out, our text going out, and then we have the shapes going out as well. I want to adjust the spacing on that. Don't actually take the shape and drag it like this, because then you cut off the animation. Move the animation first and then drag that out. Okay, I think that's looking good. So we have that coming in, we have my name there, and then we have it going out. So let's go ahead and select all of this and let's group that together. Now we can have this be, I'm going to rename it to like lower third. There we go. And then now that will come in, and there we go. Now I can reuse this over and over. I've spent a lot of time just kind of getting that right, but I can reuse it by right-clicking here and going to Add to Library. As soon as I do that, now any new project, if I come into New Project here, any new project, I can go into my library here, and then I can just grab, drag, and drop that lower third in. And then I could just go in and change the name if I wanted to. So it allows you, if you spend a lot of time on these little lower thirds or these transitions or so forth, you can go in and easily change it, but reuse it for different projects. You could even, if I right click on this, I can go to export asset. And if I export this asset out, notice how it saves this little zip file. I can send that zip file to other people on my team. If they double click on it, it's going to install it to Camtasia in their library, and they can use it as well. So it's a nice way to be able to make this stuff reusable and to share it out with other people. I'm going to close that project here and go back to this project. So now we have a nice, I'm going to zoom out here, move my cursor or my view here. So now we have this nice lower third. You may want to play with the timing there, but now you can see we also have that crop, that circle crop at the bottom. So hopefully this has given you some tips and tricks on how to use Camtasia and how to go beyond just screen recording and adding these animations and lower thirds and titles and so forth. What else do you want to learn about with Camtasia? Let me know in the comments on my YouTube channel, and let me know what other templates you want to see, what other things you're trying to figure out with Camtasia as well. I'm happy to take a look at those. Also, if you haven't checked out my website, go ahead and check out my website at learningdojo.ninja. You can check out all my previous blog posts on XAPI and Storyline and other augmented reality, other topics like that. You can also download templates, and I'm thinking about having future Camtasia templates that you can download here as well. And then courses, Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom Scorm, and HTML5 Video. So hopefully you found some of these tips and tricks useful, and you can start using them inside of your own Camtasia projects. If you found it useful, go to my YouTube channel and like and subscribe on YouTube. That way you get notified of all future videos that come out. But again, thanks everyone for tuning in, and I'll see you in the next video.